ചീഫ് ഓഫ് എയർ സ്റ്റാഫ് എയർ ചീഫ് മാർഷൽ എൻ എ കെ ബ്രൗൺ, സയന്റിഫിക് അഡ്വൈസർ ഡോക്ടർ വി കെ സരസ്വത്, സെക്രട്ടറി ഡിഫൻസ് പ്രൊഡക്ഷൻ ശ്രീ ആർ കെ മാത്തൂർ, ശ്രീ ജി ഇളങ്കോവൻ, ഡോക്ടർ തമിൾമണി, ഡിസ്റ്റിംഗ്വിഷ് ഗസ്റ്റ്, ഡിസ്റ്റിംഗ്വിഷ് സയന്റിസ്റ്റ്, റെപ്രസെന്റേറ്റീവ് ഓഫ് ദ ഇന്ത്യൻ ഇൻഡസ്ട്രി, ഡിസ്റ്റിംഗ്വിഷ് അക്കാഡമിഷ്യൻസ്, സീനിയർ ഓഫീസേഴ്സ് ഫ്രം ദ ഇന്ത്യൻ എയർഫോഴ്സ്, മൈ ഡിയർ സ്റ്റുഡൻസ്, ഫ്രണ്ട്സ് ഫ്രം ദ മീഡിയ, ടുഡേ ഐ അറ്റൻഡിംഗ് ദിസ് സെമിനാർ. I am more happy than last year. Last year when I started speaking, then only I understood that the future of our country, even though they are invited for the seminar, they are in a different room. Now all the students are inside. So I am very happy about that. It is a pleasure to be with you all today for the international seminar. Later in the day, eminent technologists and scientists would be speaking at the plenary sessions. At this 9th edition of the Aero India seminar, many scientists, engineers, professionals, CEOs and academicians have already delivered their papers yesterday. In the past, the organization of the seminar have chosen various themes pertaining to aerospace technologies and products to address specific issues in those areas. The theme at this year's seminar is challenges in design to deployment of the aerospace products. The theme is particularly relevant for today's aerospace scenario. But even though the theme is very relevant, after hearing Chief of Air Staff and SA2RM, I have decided I must confine to few areas, because unlike them, I am an expert. Actually, I am a layman on this area of aerospace. So I will not go into details about the theme of the seminar. We have been designing, developing, producing and deploying a few aircraft, unmanned aerial vehicles and missiles. A successful design is one that properly translates the design into an acceptable product meeting the requirements of the end users. This is not an easy task, and the development and production agencies face several challenges along the way. LCA Tejas is undergoing several flights and ground tests to meet the requirements of the users. The very long gestation period of development in aerospace products introduces elements of additional challenges for all the agencies. Aerospace systems have become highly avionics and software intensive. Such technologies change at a mind-boggling pace. It is imperative to ensure that the user requirements are met and the design of these requirements are finalized as early as possible. The product, along with the technologies available on the date, should be released with regular updates to take care of the technological advancements. Research and development efforts in our country are mostly government funded and by government agencies. That too, very meager. This is where private industry can help both in research and development efforts. As well as in production, industries have several opportunities to participate in major defense acquisition programs by making use of our offset policies. If our private industries also invest in research and development, I am confident that the requirement of our usage would be met much easier than is the case now. After hearing the Air Force Chief and SA, I would also like to add few words about the research and development. I said earlier, at the moment, R&D sector is mainly funded by the government. Even though government is funding, I'm not satisfied that the fund allotted for R&D. Government also must spend more money on R&D. And private sector spending on R&D is very, very poor, except one or two sectors like pharmaceutical and other sectors. Everybody is telling India got the largest scientific pool in the world. And our GDP growth is also now commendable. Industry is growing very fast. Economy is growing fast. All right, everything is all right. But if you want to keep the momentum of this growth, you have to invest more on R&D. What is the real strength of US or Europe or any advanced countries? Their real strength is technology and efficient management and all-round efficiency. Don't be offended if I may say frankly. Here, one of the major areas of strength of our industry is cheap labor and cheap natural resources. Don't expect this situation will continue ever. This will change. Then also you have to survive. And you have to move forward. And our aim is sky. You want to become one of the top 3 or 4 or 5 of the world economy. So you have to move very fast. I don't think the present atmosphere of getting cheap natural resources for the industry, both private and public, will continue for a long time. That day will go at the earliest. That is my opinion. It will happen. And I don't think cheap labor also will be available for a long time. That era also will be over. You will have to give the working class their due. And you will have to give reasonable price for the precious natural resources. Because natural resources are not unlimited. So it is asset of the public, asset of the government. So you will have to give more money, reasonable price for the natural resources. So in this atmosphere, changing atmosphere, the industry wants to survive, both private and public. You must spend more R&D, and Indian industry, both public and private, must have the best technology in the world. Otherwise, it will be difficult to compete with other countries. And also, you must improve your efficiency in all-round efficiency. So you must give more emphasis on spending more money on R&D. Government also spend more money. Government is spending, but not enough. Spend more money. Private industry must state their miserly attitude in spending more money on R&D. If you can state this approach, I am sure, because we have the scientists. I am proud of Indian scientists. So if you can spend more money on R&D, India can become one of the major technologically advanced country, then only in future we can move forward. That is my considered view. I am glad that our designers and production agencies have been by and large successful in facing many challenges, as is evident from Tejas, replaced advanced light helicopters, Dhruv Akash missiles, BrahMos, and some other aerospace projects. As he was explaining in detail about all these areas, and he is very proud about the achievement. Not only he, I am also really proud of the achievements of our industry. Yeah. Really proud. The moment I joined the university that time onwards, I am an all-out supporter for scientists and DRDO. When I took over at that time, 99% of the talk about DRDO was only attack, criticism. Always they are getting brickbats. No bouquet. Now, a mixed one. They are getting more bouquet now. More achievements are there. More achievements are there. That is why the government of India, for the first time, recognized, give hat trick to them. Two Padma Bhushans and one Padma Shri. Dr. Saraswat, Dr. Shivdharabulla, and Dr. Avinash. Two got Padma Bhushan, one got Padma Shri. So we recognize their achievements. We are proud of their achievements. We are proud of Indian scientists' achievements. And as Defence Minister, I am proud of DRDO's achievements. But, partially I am with Air Force Chief also. Because I am the Minister for Defence. I am not the Minister for DRDO only, Minister for Defence. I am Minister of the country. So, I am happy about your achievements. But I am not fully happy about your achievements. You have to go much more speed. Delay in delivery is a real problem. Tejas, I'm very happy. I was here in Bangalore to attend the IOC, Initial Operational Clearance of Tejas. Saraswat was here, your predecessor was here. Now, you are now hoping to read the second IOC. But I'm becoming impatient. I'm waiting for the FOC, Final Operational Clearance. So that day also must come. So while congratulating all of you for your achievements, I'm telling you, please again try to speed up your all this process, and you must try to reduce the time for research, development, and production. Delays we must avoid, and quality we must improve also. I wish to strongly emphasize that all the stakeholders must hold regular deliberations and solve their problems within the initial stages of any achievement or program. Just now I was telling SA and Air Force Chief and the Secretary of Defense Production that now you must focus on one area of major breakthrough in the HAL. Now Air Force got Pilatus for the training, they got Hawks, but they have problems in IJT. That project is delayed. So we must focus on IJT and we must make it a reality. So next aerospace, this year's seminar, we must be able to tell this conference a success story about IJT also. That way, HAL chairman is nodding his head. Good, but we used to make it a reality with your team. Our mantra must be, join us in day-to-day working. If you wish to succeed in reducing the content of the imported weaponry, and increase the indigenous content, only thing is, you have to work together. Air Force Chief was telling that we must avoid import and produce indigenously. That is the motto of the government. That is why the new defense policy, new defense production policy, main aim is reduce the dependence on import, more indigenous production. Now we are giving more space to the Indian private industry also. Even though HAL is little unhappy and little angry, ultimately we agreed with the Air Force and DRDO to give a chance to the Indian private industry with foreign collaborators. That is why the transport aircraft, our replacement, you are given to private sector. It's an example. It's a beginning. You will succeed if you give this kind of project, you will come forward. In a way, it is a healthy competition to HIL also. At the moment, HIL has no rivals in India. I want always competition. So, but with this competition, HIL will also further, they will also see that somebody is coming behind us. Now they feel there is no competition. So that is why they are sometime becoming, no reflection on anybody in the HIL. But I want some rivals to HIL. That only HIL also will become one of the world's world-class aerospace manufacturers in the country. I hope that the deliberations since yesterday would definitely help everyone in achieving the desired objectives. I am really glad that as in the past, the strength of the students at this edition of the seminar is fairly high. I request the students, you should not only participate, you should actively participate in the deliberations. They are the future of India, and they should learn valuable lessons from these deliberations. This will enable them to make a more meaningful contribution in the future. I congratulate all the organizers for bringing together such learned experts from various parts of the world under one roof. May the deliberations at the seminar be fruitful. With these words, I wish the seminar all success. Thank you. Jai Hind.